Welcome back to the second quarter of the Bobby Dupree Show, and I forgot to introduce my sidekick, Mr. Andrew.
Good morning. Just call me Santa's little helper.
Santa's little helper. You're right. You want to get a couple of our sponsors, then we're going to go into a couple of obituaries.
I can do that. Let's start with, how about this sponsor? I'll start with Carl's Thrifty Way right here just south of the station at South Union Street in Opelousas. Carl's Thrifty Way, all your medicinal needs. It's prescription drugs, over-the-counter drugs. They can help you with compounding multiple medications. You know, this time of the year especially, if you're traveling to go meet your family, maybe you're going to go visit the kids somewhere, maybe you're going to visit the parents somewhere. Why bring all those bottles, a bunch of bottles? And legally, the sheriff will tell you, you can't just take all those bottles and throw them into one bottle. You've got to have the right prescription on the bottle. They can compound multiple medications for you at Carl's so that you can easily take those medicines and be nice and legal and everything is good. You know, instead of having that whole tackle box full of things you got to go through,
yeah,
you
like,
have one.
Like mine.
You know, plenty of folks have, you know, by the time you take the cholesterol and the blood pressure and the this and the that, they can make that easy for you to take. Carl's also has all the Christmas decorations, redo your whole house for you, basically. They'll go in and they'll do the big wreaths to match your house and do it proportional to what you need. They'll actually go buy your house to do that. And they also do plenty of Christmas gifts and gift wrapping as well. One more sponsor, let's go with LHC Group. You and I were talking earlier about the Breakfast with Santa, and LHC Group was there. And I don't have all my photos this week. Next week I'll have all the photos. I didn't have time to develop them, you know, when it's so busy with the breakfast.
And we're running pretty late as it is.
Yeah, and I'm gonna get to some LHC photos
and
in a little while.
Steve has to go and tape the swamp and roll
tonight. So we were in a rush. But LHC Group, all about helping people. Earlier this morning when we got there, Keith Myers, one of the founders. I don't think he's CEO anymore. He's like chairman of the board, I guess, nowadays. They bumped him upstairs from the big picture.
Mm-hmm.
And he has done a very, very good job putting the whole project together at LHC, where they specialize in home health care from therapy to the equipment. We're talking about the special beds, chairs, the oxygen equipment, the therapists you need at home, the special doctors that come in. Maybe it's hospice care, maybe it's palliative care. They do all that as well. They've got a health and wellness center here in Opelousas as well. You and I talked to some of the therapy nurses, Teresa today, I guess she was a Sebastian, one of the Sebastians. You know, we all talk about that whole big batch of Sebastians. we talked with her quite a bit today, and of course, Brandy Burley Fontenot we talked to as well, who's always very, very active with the group. But LHC Group, it's all about helping people.
And Keith, that's one of his first times coming to the event
breakfast.
Itself.
Yeah.
He always had representatives and his check's always there, but
he had a few minutes to come by this
morning. He brought a little personal check today, and it's a nice little big check.
And it looked like it was pretty clear between him and I think Harold Taylor, and then Earl Taylor. Earl Taylor was there, and I was there. I think that makes Palmetto the highest per capita group. That's 4 out of the 200 that lived there at one time. That's a high percentage. Yeah. I mean, you know.
Ginger, Keith's wife was not there, Ginger, and I bet she was doing some charity work
somewhere
else.
She's very active with cancer type charities, which she does bunch of work. She's lost a family member to cancer.
That's correct.
So just a very, very good group of folks there. That's you. I got it. Don't worry about it. I got it. All right. I just killed it. How about the Christmas parade here in Opelousas? We've got Opelousas Children's Christmas Parade is coming up on December the 12th. You were asking about that a minute ago. That's Thursday, December the 12th. It'll be floats, high school marching bands, cartoon characters, and of course, Santa Claus will be there. Starts at 6 p.m. They're going to line up at St. Landry Catholic Church over there at the beginning of North Street and go all the way to Crestwell Lane. $25 for cars and $50 for trailers. The deadline, you got to register by December 9th. You can call the Museum and Interpretive Center, 948-2529.
And over in Honorville, there's going to be a real nice 6th annual Christmas parade, a Mini-Mart production, Papa Joe's. And we're talking about Miss Beverly Stelly and Joe Cagnino. This is their 6th edition, as I said. And that's going to be Saturday, December the 7th in Honorville. Enter under your float quick as you can for the Christmas evening parade, $10 entry fee. And they are going to have, the evening parade starts at 5:30, and the lineup for the parade starts at 4:30 on last Street, and they're going to have music by Wallace Trahan and Rice and Gravy. No cover charge for the music.
Miss Shirley will be there too, I'm sure.
And Miss Shirley will be there. You know Wallace that. And Shirley Trahan and the Rice and Gravy Band. And sneak preview of our new event hall. Okay, well, now that's something new that they're going to have there in Orneville.
And that missed call we had a minute ago was from the Kazan Hotel. I just want to give you that. Remember, Wallace very involved with the Kazan Hotel.
Yeah, they're the ones that owned renovated it for a good while, and then the Chasson family.
Correct.
Blaine and his wife, Larry Zerang's daughter. She's doing real good in real estate. I can say everything, but her name, very attractive.
You ever
girl.
Been to the Archway?
Yes.
Back when Larry had the Archway. How about Classics? When he had Classics, too, we'd go there and eat oysters at lunchtime. And
Oh, Larry something. Nah, he probably has the largest bail bond agency in Louisiana.
Probably so. And back in those days, the little hostess was a little 17-year-old girl named Melanie Lee. The now Melanie Lee LaBeouf. Hi. Mm-hmm. I mean, I remember all that. Don't forget about the Christmas parade. Devery Henderson, star of LSU with the Kentucky Miracle football catch, and also
that I witnessed.
Saints Super Bowl champion. He'll be the grand marshal. This Friday night is Le Vieux Village, the old French village here in Opelousas. We'll have the lighting of the village, and you can go out with your kids. There's going to be music and balloons and choirs, and everybody's involved. Andre Pont Printing, Super One. ShopRite, Clico, everybody's involved. Go by. You're going to have a good time. Bring the kids. Family fun.
And UL, while they got defeated last weekend, with kind of a disappointment to UL Monroe, they ended up that same night signing an agreement to again attend the New Orleans Bowl game, which they've represented the Sunbelt Conference, which they're a member of, the last 2 years and have won the last 2 years.
So this would be
three in a row.
So they're University of Louisiana at Lafayette. They lost to University of Louisiana at Monroe. And in the bowl, they'll play the original University of Louisiana. That's Tulane's original name.
Really?
So that'll show you how it all comes back around. Now, I'm also told, I don't know if it's true, I heard this on sports radio, that the Independence Bowl offered the Cajuns more money to go to Shreveport than they were offered to go to New Orleans. But they still decide to go to New Orleans. I guess it's to help the alumni. But let me tell you, from a football standpoint, $750,000 extra, if that's what the difference was, and it sounds like it's that big.
But the Independence Bowl can't pay that kind of money.
They got a huge sponsor, bigger sponsors. That's the key, the sponsors.
Really?
So I don't know. I don't know what, and I know they want to award the alumni because alumni have helped them. I mean, that's what's helped them get to this level. But boy, sometimes you got to take a less prestigious city, maybe. You know, maybe Shreveport isn't as glamorous as New Orleans, okay? But you got to take a bigger bowl sometimes.
And you can't hardly get a room on the weekends in Shreveport.
No.
They're blocked up.
The casinos are already booked up.
Casinos have them all booked up. It would be tough to get a couple of thousand rooms.
But UL's at that magic spot where they want to blow through, and they almost.
Well, you're talking about that. The UL Lafayette Foundation recognizes distinguished donors. They raised about $4.6 million from probably a total of 20, 25 business and individuals in the Lafayette area. Some attended college there, some didn't. They have businesses there. They see what a good athletic program does for an institution.
It gives you mind share, as they say. It gets you in people's minds.
And and I saw a couple of names that I recognized, and of course one of them, my nephew,
Dr. Reggie Dupre
Logistics.
Right.
Used to be Dupre Transport.
And his lovely wife, Marie.
Marie, yep. And mustn't forget Cody and Will, the mom and daddy.
So
too, you know,
Cody is smart.
Cody's got a little piece of that
well,
action.
Education, too. He's a well-educated man, too. Cool. Right.
From UL. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep.
The Dupre boys all did well.
Yeah. Mom and daddy, I guess they pretty happy. Turned out pretty good. And Mama had gone to the eighth grade, I think, and Daddy had gone to the sixth grade, is if I remember the numbers correctly. Very little schooling. But they were self-educated in the sense that they read the newspaper. I love newspapers, and I picked that up from Daddy, watching him reading the newspaper in a little spell he would get. And I still recommend holding that paper in my hand.
It's
I know
good.
I could watch it on my cell phone, and I could learn how to turn on a computer and all that stuff, but I'm not going there yet.
We're going to do this. Remember, we got some video from the party yesterday, Cerebral Palsy Clinic. You want to let them run that video right now?
Right now.
Go ahead and show that video, and if you can help us out with Alpazarra Cerebral Palsy Clinic and our Breakfast with Santa fundraiser still going on, even though the breakfast is done, we need your help to help these kids. This is some footage from Santa at the kids' party yesterday.
And their families, and then there were two groups that entertained the children, and I'm speaking of probably two classes from the Academy of the Sacred Heart.
And from St. John Birchman's, the boys' school
the boys
and the girls' school.
And the girls' school. A real nice group, and there might be a
Jade
picture.
Jade Goins there?
That the, on the right, sitting down, that's the girls
and
right there.
Major there that you're shaking hands with. And a lot of the kids that have come to the clinic for quite a few years, a lot of them have come from as toddlers and babies all the way up to being teens and even older. Around the clinic, so you can see a lot of the kids there.
Boy, I tell you what, no wonder everybody's telling me I need to quit losing weight. I
You're getting
won't
slim.
Be anything left to
That's
me.
That's right. There's Major there, and there you are.
And Miss Susan,
who's our main physical therapist
That's
there
correct.
At the clinic.
Very good, very yeah. conscientious. The parents love her.
Right. And there we go.
That one had a real good smile.
And that's little Lindsay Abair that we have fun with each year. She sat with us at the end of the breakfast.
There's Jade.
Yep, Jade again. Her dad's Charles Goins, who's the president
who's
of the
president
clinic right
of
now.
The clinic right now.
And they get to get excited. All the kids who don't get excited for Santa Claus, even I have to get excited for Santa Claus.
Yeah, you're right. Give each one of them a little cash contribution, gift.
And some and
candy.
Gifts as well.
Yep. And then they get gifts from,
I think there's Mr. Charles Goins there.
That's the clinic buys these or donations?
I think some of that's donations. I think maybe the ladies with even the doll and toy fund, I think, get involved as well.
Okay, because Janice Kerrville was there.
Correct.
I complimented her for the years.
Correct.
She's spearheaded this
I'm
drive.
I'm going to have info on her group, too, in a few minutes as well. But you can see they're all getting clothes and toys. And
look at that. If that's not sweet, oh.
Very excited. And a lot of people there. Some of them are family members you see with the kids, and some of the caregivers themselves. They've got nurses or assistants or therapists that help them directly. A lot of our kids can't come to any of the big party that we have for the adults because physically they require so much interaction, so much help to get it done. And we had a lighter, you know, some years we have heavier crowds, some years we have lighter crowds, depending on what the kids are doing, what the weather's doing. But you can see all the young ladies from the academy singing.
Now, here's
the
young boys.
At St. John Birchman's. I think it's juniors and seniors that were singing with the boys. The first graduating class from St. John Birchman's.
I didn't realize that the first graduating class was already, boy, time flies. It looks like yesterday they opened up and they only did it on a little...
Just to start the small group.
Yep.
We're going to cut to a commercial break. We'll see you folks on the other side of 1 minute.